You know, Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is an established fact. He led the Taraweeh prayer only for 3 nights. He came out and prayed Salatul Taraweeh with companions only thrice, just in the whole of his life, in the whole lifetime, only thrice. Then he never came out. So then the people used to pray Salatul Taraweeh separately, individually in their houses or in the mosque, wherever. There was no Jamaat prayer for Taraweeh till Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, his period. So he saw the people praying Salatul Taraweeh separately, individually. He thought it would be better if they should be combined collectively, they should pray it collectively in Jama'ah. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu appointed the first man to lead Salatul Taraweeh, that was Hazrat Ubay bin Ka'b radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Next night he came out and he saw the people reading, praying Salatul Taraweeh collectively in Jama'ah. He was happy. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when he saw, he stated, Ni'matil bid'atu hazihi. This is a very good bid'ah. This is a very good bid'ah. So in fact, now the founder of the concept is that every bid'ah is not bad. Every bid'ah is not bad. Bid'ah means a new act, an innovation. That every innovation is not a bad act. There are good innovations and there are bad innovations. So the founder of this concept, not founder, rather we would say, the first interpreter, the first one who declared that every innovation is not bad innovation, there are good innovations, the first man who declared this concept, the first authority in the history of Islam, is the second Orthodox Caliph, Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala. And you say, where does this authority rely? So this authority is quoted by Imam Bukhari. Authority is Imam Bukhari. He has quoted Sayyidina Umar's authority. Jami al-Bukhari, Hadith, Kitab Salatul Taraweeh, Sahih Bukhari. Babu Fadli Man Qama Ramadan. Fadli Qiyam Ramadan. Fadlu Man Qama Ramadan. Hadith number 3. Chapter number 31 in Kitab Salatul Taraweeh. Third Hadith. Reported on Urwa ibn Zubair, on Abdul Rahman bin Abdul Qari, annahu qala kharajtu ma Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu laylatan fi Ramadan ila al-masjid faizan nasu awza'un mutafarriqun yusalli ar-rajulu li nafsihi wa yusalli ar-rajulu fa yusalli bi salatihi ar-rahat fa qala Umar inni ara law jama'tu ha'ula'i ala qari'in wahidin lakana amthal. ثم عزم فجمعهم على ابي بن ابي كعب ثم خرجت معه ليله اخرى والناس يصلون بصلاه قاريهم. Now they were praying Taraweeh in Jamaat. قال عمر رضي الله تعالى نعم البدعه هذه. This is a very good bid'ah which I have found it. So if mazallah, every bid'ah is dalala and it will go to Jahannam, hell, then what would you say about Umar? Where would he go? Founder of this bid'ah. If you say, no, this is not bid'ah, this would be a jahala. Umar himself is saying, ni'mal bid'ah tihaz. This is a good bid'ah. And Imam Bukhari is narrating, this is a good bid'ah. Who is better scholar than Hazrat Imam Bukhari and Sayyidina Umar? There is no question of any debate after that. He says, Ni'mal bid'atu hazihi. Wallati tanamun an afdalu min allati yaqum min allatina yaqumun. This is hadith of Bukhari. So the founder of this concept, this deviation, is Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu anhu. And then the first narrator is Imam Bukhari. I don't say first narrator, now come to other. The first narrator of this hadith of bid'ah hasana, ni'mal bid'ah, is Imam Malik. Imam Bukhari came afterward. comes afterwards. I have given you the reference of Sahih Bukhari. Now have the reference of Muwatta Imam Malik. So the first narrator of Ni'm al-Bidah, good Bidah, a very good Bidah, the first narrator is Imam Malik. Then is Imam Shafi'i. Then comes Imam Bukhari. And Imam Bihaqi and other Aimma. Now, can we say all of these Imam right from Hazrat Umar, all of these were Barelvis? What is Jahala? This is Muwatta Imam Malik. Kitab us-Salat fi Ramadan. Chapter 2nd. Babu ma ja'a fi Qiyam Ramadan. Second chapter. Hadith number 3. The same words which Imam Bukhari has narrated. The same words have been narrated by Imam Malik. Then he says, فَجَامَعَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أُبَيِّ بْنِ أَبِي كَعْبٍ قَالَ ثُمَّ خَرَجْتُ مَعَهُ لَيْلَةً أُخْرَى وَالنَّاسُ يُصَلُّونَ بِصَلَاةِ قَارِئِهِمْ فَقَالَ عُمَرْ نِعْمَةِ الْبِدْعَةُ هَذِهِ. So I've given you two authorities. So now some people say, no, this is no acceptable division of good bid'ah and wrong bid'ah. Every bid'ah is wrong. So now they should cancel all ahadith of, cancel the Sahih Bukhari, and they should cancel Muwatta Imam Malik. They should cancel Imam Shafi, and first of all, they should cancel Sayyidina Umar radiyallahu anhu. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Now come to Ibn Asir. An-Nihaya fi Gharib al-Hadith wal-Asr. A great muhaddith. He was born in 544. Died in 606. He says, fi hadith Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhu fi qiyam Ramadan. Now he gives the inference, Imam Ibn Asir. He says, ni'matil bid'atu hazihi. He says, now it is an established fact, al bid'atu bid'atan. He says, bid'at is of two kinds, bid'atan. Bid'atun huda wa bid'atun dalal. Bid'atul hidayah wa bid'atul dalala. One bid'ah is based on hidayah, guidance, right act, and one bid'ah is based on dalala. And when Holy Prophet ﷺ speaks kullu bid'atin dalala, the muhaddithin a'imma says kullu bid'atin means kullu bid'atin sayyatin dalala. Kullu bid'atin mazmumatin dalala. They say it means, Holy Prophet meant this. Every bad bid'ah, wrong bid'ah is dalala. Kullu dalalatin finnar. And every dalala will go to hell. If you don't divide and you don't create this meaning, qualify kullu bid'atin with sayyia and mazmuma. If you don't qualify the word kullu bid'atin with sayyia and mazmuma, then mazallah, Sayyidina Umar himself comes into the first fatwa, becomes the target of first fatwa. And then you will see, I'm coming to another Sahih Bukhari hadith, Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq becomes the target of first fatwa. If you don't differentiate. So he says, bid'atu hudan wa bid'atu dalal. Bid'atu al-hidayah wa bid'atu dalala. And he described the definition Aimma gave. Fama kana fi khilafi ma amar Allah bihi wa rasuluhu fahuwa fi hayyazid dham wal inkar. All those news acts which come directly in conflict of Allah's commandment or commandment of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they come under bid'atul dalala. وَمَا كَانَ وَاقِعًا تَحْتَ مَا نَدَبَ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ وَخَصَّ عَلَيْهِ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولَهُ هُوَ مِنَ الْمَدْحِ. And all those news acts which come under the generality of righteousness, generality of goodness, under the general and common idea of goodness, khair, commendability, under the general and common idea, general and common idea of commendability, he says, all those come under the madha, al-bida al-mamduha, al-bida al-mahmuda, al-bida al-mamduha, fahuwa min al-af'alil mahmuda. And now he brings another hadith, hadith of Sahih Muslim. And Imam Nawawi has also in Riyaz al-Salihin narrated the same hadith. And he bases other thing on another. He says, man sanna fil islami sunnatan hasanatan कान लहू अजरुहा व अजरु मन अमिल बिहा व मन सन्ना, दिस इज अदर अथॉरिटी. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई हैव बीन गिविंग द अथॉरिटी ऑन डिवीजन ऑफ बिदा हसना एंड सैया और मजमूमा एंड महमूदा, गुड एंड बैड इनोवेशन. अप टू नाउ आई गेव यू द अथॉरिटीज ऑफ इमाम बेहकी, इमाम सयूती, अथॉरिटी ऑफ इमाम इब्नुल असीर, अथॉरिटी ऑफ इमाम बुखारी, अथॉरिटी ऑफ इमाम मालिक एंड अथॉरिटी ऑफ इमाम शाफी एंड अथॉरिटी ऑफ सैयदना उमर. नाउ अथॉरिटी ऑफ होली प्रॉफिट सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम हिमसेल्फ, ही हैज क्रिएटेड दिस काइंड. सो होली प्रॉफिट हिमसेल्फ इज द फाउंडर ऑफ द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ बिदआ महमूदा एंड मजमूमा, हसना एंड सैया, फाउंडर ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट. एंड दिस इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड थ्रू हदीस सही.